Avi Loeb, renowned theoretical physicist, Harvard professor, head of the Galileo Project, joins us once again. Professor Loeb, always wonderful to see you. And let's start with this. I mean, you are one of the most outspoken voices pushing for these images from NASA. They're convinced it's just a comet. Are you convinced?
Thanks for having me, Natasha. Well, the verdict should not be decided by administrators at NASA. It should be decided by the data. And in fact, the best image that they offered at the press conference indicated that there is fuzz elongated. There is some glow in front of the object in the direction of motion, not in the direction of the sun, as we might expect from evaporation of pockets of ice as a result of illumination by sunlight, or the push of the gas that comes out of those pockets of ice opposite to the direction of the sun. Instead, we see it perpendicular to the direction of the sun, to in the direction of motion. And the question is whether this is a beam of light or a beam of particles that are used to clear out any micrometeorites that might be impacting the object as it moves forward. So to me, it raises more questions than it answers. And then I just calculated today that in fact, 3I Atlas gets near Jupiter on March 16th, 2026, at a distance which is exactly identical to the distance inside of which Jupiter's gravity dominates over the sun's gravity. And this coincidence is to within one part in 26,000. Okay, quite amazing. It's remarkably exactly the right distance for Jupiter's gravity to dominate when 3I Atlas comes closest to it. And in fact, the non-gravitational acceleration that was reported after it came closest to the sun, there was some push that was noticed in its trajectory, some slight deviation from the original path, is needed in order to bring it exactly to that location. So by now I have even more puzzles, and the fact that NASA ignores the anomalies that 3I Atlas had, meaning the very small likelihood that it lies in the plane of the planets around the sun, and its very large size, a million times more massive object than the first interstellar object, you know, that obviously allows them to make a very confident statement that it's a comet, but I'm still very intrigued by these anomalies.
Wow. Okay. I mean, it did feel like a very confident statement from them. I want to pull this up on the other side, because you pulled no punches when writing about NASA's certainty on Medium. You write, quote, imaginative scientists master the humility to learn something new from anomalies rather than display the arrogance of expertise. Those are scientific fighting words. Professor Loeb, what specific anomalies right now are standing out to you the most that you want NASA to be more open to?
Well, the most important ones are the large mass of this object. We don't expect such a massive package to be delivered once per decade into the inner solar system, given the mass reservoir of rocks in interstellar space. They didn't even get to that. Then, of course, the fact that the trajectory lies in the plane of the planets. And finally, what I realized today, that it comes exactly at the right distance from Jupiter for Jupiter's gravity to dominate. So if it wants to release some probes near Jupiter, that's where it needs to be. And just think about the fact that humanity, the human species, emerged on Earth only over the past few million years, whereas this object probably started its journey billions of years ago. So Jupiter is easy to recognize, the biggest planet in the solar system, and perhaps that's what attracted their visit. We tend to think that it's all about us.
Professor Loeb, I have to ask quickly, is there anything in particular you still want us to do scientifically when 3I Atlas is closest to us?
Yes, we see seven jets coming from it based on the latest images from amateur astronomers. And I would like to know the speed of the jets and the composition of the jets, because that would tell us whether it's naturally produced. These jets are produced by pockets of ice illuminated by sunlight, or if the speed of the gas in them is much greater, it would imply a technological thruster associated generating each of these jets.
Every time we speak, it provides so much scope for the imagination, and I'm so glad you're asking these questions. Professor Avi Loeb, great to see you. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.